common to all.
What can I possibly do to encourage such an impulse in you?
You don't have to do a thing. Chemically, we're already quite sympathetic.
You're the most incredible creature I've ever met. Ninotchka. Ninotchka.
You repeat yourself.
So there is the Russian version of the film, and so in the Mateo Gil version, she's the Russian scientist who comes over to America with the it was called positivism, and kind of Marxist scientific ideologies. So in the Mateo Gil film, it's this guy, the physicist, who plays the role of Nonoshka. He's kind of like frustrated. He believes the way he understands the formulas are the way they should be, but he's struggling to. He's like forcing his formulas on her and his other girlfriend, and talks about them to his friend. So it's kind of like he doesn't have the formulas completely worked out in his mind, just like Anoshka didn't have them worked out in her mind. But it's interesting. It's a learning experience. So here's the MGM version of this Ninotchka thing. They talk about when the electromagnetic of the female meets the electromagnetic of the female. So here we're going to look at a little video clip here, because you'll see them talk about the forces in the film. Mostly it's gravitational. But it's the gravito-electromagnetic force that works on people. But here we'll just watch a little clip.
When the electromagnetic of the he-male meets the electromagnetic of the female, if right away she should say, "This is the male." It's a chemical reaction, that's all. And though your fascist may answer with hisses, the same applies when your misters and misses. A diddle diddle with middle class kisses. It's a chemical reaction, that's all. Say in love with you I fall, and in love with me you also fall. Though the
just a pause on this part here. When you fall in love, like she's talking about here, this is more than metaphor. So when a rock falls off a cliff, it falls through the gravitational force from a higher height to a lower height. But when humans fall, they're falling through what's called a thermodynamic potential. And it's from a high potential to a lower potential, and this name of the potential is called Gibbs energy.
Conducted faction calls it mutual attraction. It's a chemical reaction, that's all. As in the case of invertebrates Cambrian, as in the case of fishes Devonian, as in the case of amphibians Permian, as in the case of reptiles Triassic or Jurassic, merely read in the book by Kamichev, which has now become a classic. When the electromagnetic of the he-male meets the electromagnetic of the female, if right away she should say, "Come and be male," it's a chemical reaction, that's all. You do not believe Kamichev?
No, ma'am.
Then what is your theory?
My theory is that there is no theory.
You are tracking. That's right. There obviously must be scientific reasons.
There are reasons, but they have nothing to do with Consolidated Edison. I love the looks of you, the lure of you.
Okay, so there's no book name. This Kamachev book is just kind of a fiction. And there's never really been anybody's ever written about the electromagnetic theory of men and women attracting, pulling together, aside from myself. And I've read more than 1,000 books on this subject. So next we're going to look at, when digging into the film, we're just going to quickly look at the overview of the contents of, so there's this guy singing this part here. So here we're going to look at this table of contents of human chemical thermodynamics. So we can see where the movie is going to come through here. So, important part of the film is in the middle. Probably the core of the whole film is when the thermodynamics professor is talking about entropy. He gives the Clausius entropy formula, where dS is the entropy as an exact differential, and partial of Q over T is the partial, which means a theoretical heat divided by the absolute temperature of the system. So this is kind of the core of thermodynamics. And here we have, what is a human? Because in the film, the supermodel says a couple of times that she is, she argues about whether she is an organized collection of atoms or she is not an organized collection of atoms. She flips out the end of the film saying, I'm not atoms, or something like that. So here we have chapter 1, what is a human? We'll look at that shortly. But a human is a powered carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, plus 20 element thing. And then we have the engine chapter. So in the film, thermodynamics comes from Hero, Galileo, Gewirth, Papin, who invented the first engine that was powered by steam engine, or heat engine that was powered by combinations of fire and water added and subtracted. And then Savory, Newcomen, and Watt. So in the film, you'll see the astrophysicist guy attempts to make a steam engine in a little tub of water. Next we have physical, chemical, mathematical preliminary to understanding human chemical thermodynamics. And they don't really talk about this too much here in the film, because Mateo Gil supposedly has only a physics background. But they do talk about, when we get to the thermodynamics chapter, so when we get The important point here to keep in mind is that in William Thomson called Q over T the thermometric assumption. And then, after reading this, presumably, Clausius in December 1854 called this the equivalence value, Q over T. So when you start hearing a lot of talk about entropy being disorder in the film, that's incorrect. In certain cases, you can say that if you add heat to a system, it becomes more spread out, and the whole thing about second law says everything tends toward disorder is what's called ignorance that's been passed along because of lack of fundamental understanding of subjects. So when we get to the point in the film, we'll talk about this a little bit. And then over here, modern chemical, this is chemical thermodynamics. They don't talk about this in the film. A little bit they talk about, let's see. Look at over here. Okay, so here is modern human chemical thermodynamics applied. So in the, we've got all these subjects, but the film, basically, they mention God in one point in the film, saying whether you believe in God or not, thermodynamics still applies. And then they said, so the film is basically, we're going to talk about relationships and love in the film coming up. Oh, and just to one more touch on the last thing here, Finodotti's is another film. You can watch it on YouTube right now, but there's no subtitles. But if you buy the DVD, you can get the English subtitles. It's pretty decent. It has probably a better script than the film we're about to watch, but less focus on thermodynamics. So you can compare the two things. But they... here's the YouTube. You can watch the movie without subscripts. But here they try to incorporate a lot of particle physics theory, which is not necessarily interesting to read, but not necessarily correct. So he says that humans are quarks, similar to quarks, and that the force of attraction is similar to the bosonic force, and that the more you try to pull people apart, the stronger the force gets. And they talk about freedom. They talk about that in the film we're going to watch here. There's a reference to Goethe's. There's Goethe's book on the left, where they say that three things have to be taken into account when erecting a building, or in this case, a metaphor for a relationship. That you're standing on the right spot, that the foundations are sound, and that it is well constructed. So this is from Goethe's Lect Affinities, when they're laying the foundation stone of one of the buildings. So then there's the Finodotti's film in Cuba, and he's talking about the foundation of these houses they're staying on the water, where they say, "I like our cottage, it's strong. Although it's built on mud, it must have a good foundation. Foundations are important, even if you can't see them." So the film here is a reference to Goethe, which is what the Francis Ford Coppola film would have looked like if it was actually made. We don't have that, so maybe in the next century we'll have a nice, beautiful version. This is a summary of how Cuba is breaking free from the Marx-Leninism ideologies, which all fell through as incorrect, and now they're starting to go towards naturalism. Here we have, just like in the book, we have four chemicals, A, B, C, D, and they're all going to on vacation. So it's just like in the sodium, water, and oxygen reaction. They're playing it out in film. And there's a summary of where the film, the movie was filmed. But this is a different movie. Well, you can all come back. You can watch this later. But the premise of the movie you're about to watch is the same. We have four characters, and they're going to talk. This movie talks about life and death, or analysis, or synthesis means coming together. Analysis means taking apart. That's the correct way you want to think about these symbols. All right. So now we're going to dig into the film.
A las emociones que rigen nuestro día a día. La naturaleza, el universo, nuestra propia existencia, están regidos por leyes bien conocidas, leyes a las que nada ni nadie puede escapar.
These laws are extremely precise, so precise that they are expressed through the language of mathematics.
The laws of nature we have yet to discover cannot be that different from the ones we already know.
We are getting close to completing a description of the universe, to understanding how reality actually works.
Sin embargo, algo había pasado desapercibido a la comunidad científica hasta ahora, y es la extraña y profunda relación entre esas leyes y nuestro comportamiento emocional. A continuación, van a comprobar cómo las leyes de la física pueden ser aplicadas a las emociones que rigen nuestro día a día. Y de entre ellas, especialmente, las de una disciplina poco conocida.
Termodinámica. Bien, ¿qué es la termodinámica? ¿Alguno de ustedes puede decírmelo? No levanten la mano todos al tiempo que me aturo yo. Como su nombre indica, la termodinámica estudia el movimiento del calor, más estrictamente las transformaciones de la energía. ¿Puede decírmelo?
Esas leyes y nuestro comportamiento. Sin embargo, algo había pasado desapercibido a la comunidad científica.
Say the scientific community has overlooked something until now. This is pretty much correct. You cannot go, take any class in the world right now. Give or take a few graduate programs, maybe in Korea or Germany, that talks about thermodynamics of emotions. So let's take a look at what he says here.
Hasta ahora, y es la extraña y profunda.
Those strange and deep relationship between those laws and our own emotional behavior. So let's just pause on this for a minute. Because in America, this was tried out by the Princeton. And it was funded by the Rockefeller Foundation, but it was shut down. At the point, it was when they started talking about thermodynamics applied to emotional behavior. And so the funding got cut off. This is kind of like the cutting off the brain of America at this point. We'll just look at a quick snippet of that. So it was called the Princeton Department of Social Physics, and it was founded by John Q. Stewart and Percy Bridgman, who's one of the big founders of 20th century thermodynamics. So they got funding for about 5 to 6 years from the Rockefeller Foundation, and they ran this social physics department at Princeton. And everything was going pretty good in terms until Warren Weaver right here shut the whole thing down because they were starting to apply thermodynamics to motion. He said, oh, I don't like this. So let's just see what we've got here. So Warren Weaver, he was religious. And he shut the whole thing down because he believed that choice comes from your soul and this is God. God governs the soul. So he said, I'm shutting you down. And if you look at the exact, I'm completely sympathetic to your approach. This is when the funding was going. But then when John Q. Stewart, who was an astrophysicist, just like the guy, the character we're going to watch in the movie right now, he got to the point where he was he was looking for connections between social phenomena and physical phenomena, like we're going to watch in the film. But when I got to the question of social values, that's when, and physical energy. I didn't really talk about energy in the film because Mateo Gil doesn't have that experience. This is where it got shut down. Okay, so right here, in 53, this quote here, Warren Weaver said he's shutting the whole thing down. So right here he says, but it is hard for me to sense how one can usefully assign quantitative measures to any significantly wide range of values in the social field. And when you link together such things as meaning, feeling, authority, and decision-making, this sounds to me like a very heterogeneous mixture. So after this, you shut down funding, because he was the guy who was signing the checks for Rockefeller Foundation. So we see this is in America. When we watch this film, one of the reasons why this film has never been made in America or is a standard subject you can take in college right now, because it's barricaded by cultural biases. So to continue.
Comportamiento emocional. A continuación, van a comprobar cómo las leyes de la física pueden ser aplicadas a las emociones que rigen nuestro día a día. Y de entre ellas, especialmente las de una disciplina poco conocida.
Termodinámica.